வணக்கம். Whatever thing or whatsoever kind the matter be, wisdom lies in inquiring and finding its real truth. Honourable Speaker and Honourable Members of Legislature, I am extremely delighted to address the fourth session of the 14th Legislative Assembly of the Union Territory of Puducherry, and I convey my heartiest greetings to all the members and of this august house on this occasion. I am filled with a deep sense of satisfaction with the initiatives taken by this government for the welfare of poor and downtrodden in the Union Territory of Puducherry. I am happy indeed to share with the Honourable Members that the general election for Lok Sabha 2019 was conducted in a free and fair manner in the Union Territory of Puducherry. I express my sincere appreciation to all the officers and staff involved in the election. Similarly, the people of Puducherry and the political parties also deserve equal appreciation. Honourable Members are aware that the financial resources of the Union Territory of Puducherry are limited and the government is constrained to strike a balance between available resources and possible expenditure. Despite financial constraints, the government has demonstrated its commitment to ensure adequate provision of funds for the welfare of the poor and the needy. The government expenditure during the last year was financially over 7,342 crores as against the revised estimates 2018-19 of 7,881 crores, which works out to 93.16%. I wish to inform the Honourable Members that notwithstanding financial constraints, this government prudently managed the finances of the Union Territory and repaid the market loan without affecting the ongoing welfare schemes. Honourable Members are aware that the gross state domestic product is one of the major fiscal indicators for determining the state's overall economy. The GSDP of the Union Territory for 2018-19 was 35,860 crores at current price, which is 11% higher than that of the previous year. The per capita income of Puducherry has also increased from 203,583,000 crores to 1718 to 220,461,1819, showing an impressive annual growth rate of 8%. With this introduction, I'd like to apprise the Honourable Members of this August House of some of the major initiatives and achievements made by the government under various sectors during the previous financial year. Agriculture and farmers' welfare. Agriculture is considered as the backbone of rural economy. In order to serve the farming community more effectively and to ensure food security, Department of Agriculture has been renamed as Department of Agriculture and Farmers' Welfare as announced in the Budget 2018-19. Various schemes for increasing the agricultural production in the Union Territory of Puducherry, such as issue of agricultural inputs at subsidized cost, transferring technological know-how to the farmers, imparting of training, etc., are being implemented. The government encourages organic farming and guidelines on organic farming practices were framed. Shortage of agricultural labours has been duly addressed by implementation of various schemes with an outlay of 89.83 thousand crores through appropriate farm mechanisation, making available the inputs at subsidised cost, sustaining the area under agriculture and horticultural crops, etc., under the scheme crop production technology. Essential agricultural inputs were distributed to the farmers at subsidized cost in Puducherry region for an amount of 118 lakhs to general farmers and 67.30 lakhs to SE farmers, benefiting around 15,652 farmers. Back-ended investment subsidy at the rate of 5,000 per hectare was given to 3,217 general farmers and 258 SE farmers with an expenditure of 1.25 crores in Puducherry region. In Karikal region, the back-ended subsidy for Thuruvai paddy crop for the year 2017-18 was provided to 609 farmers for an amount of 31 lakhs. For Samba crop for the year 2017-18 in Karikal region, back-ended investigation subsidy was extended to 3,193 general farmers and 494 SE farmers, involving an expenditure of 1.58 crores. I am glad to inform the Honourable Members that under the Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana, 22 projects involving agriculture, animal husbandry, fisheries, dairy, agriculture research and education, etc., have been approved by the Government of India for an amount of 9.48 crores. Under the Crop Insurance Scheme, 4997 farmers in Puducherry region covering 4294 hectares, 4,803 farmers covering 4,878 hectares in Karikal region, and 473 farmers covering 8,231 hectares in Yanam region have been enrolled. Under the paddy insurance scheme, 86% in Puducherry region, 96% in Karikal region, and 100% in Yanam have been covered. The regulated markets, one at Thattanchery Bedi in Puducherry region and another in Karikal region, have been integrated in the ENAM project. All the commodities coming to the market were traded electronically under the ENAM portal, and assistance of 30 lakhs was received from the Government of India for development of infrastructure in the regulated market, Thattanchery. Farmer producer organization, FPOs, were formed to supply paddy seeds and vegetable seeds to farmers for the first time in history of Puducherry. 110 women members in food security cell have been trained in beekeeping schemes so as to implement the same through women's health groups, and necessary guidelines have been notified to procure equipment through bank loan with 40% subsidy. In 2018-19 for agriculture, education, grant in aid to the tune of 13 crores was released to Pajan Goa. Animal husbandry. In view of the high potential for generating substantial income, especially for the rural population production of high protein food, this government has given priority for maintaining healthy livestock and sustained productivity. During 2018-19, 49,200 metric tons of milk, 113.73 lakh eggs, and 14,627 metric tons of meat have been produced in the Union Territory of Puducherry. A detailed project report for modernizing the existing dairy plant at a cost of 34 crores has been submitted to Government of India. Besides giving free treatment and preventive vaccination to 3,24,242 cases of livestock, poultry and pet animals, 64 health camps were conducted periodically throughout the Union Territory of Puducherry. 59,862 artificial inseminations were done to produce desirable future livestock, and 20,819 calves of desirable super germs plasm were born. Cattle and poultry shows were also conducted. Scheme for provision of ear tags showing 12-digit unique identification number to all breedable cattle, including milch animals in Puducherry, for monitoring milk production and health status of cattle through information network for animal productivity and health. Scheme is implemented in this Union Territory. For encouraging poultry production, 8,214 dual-purpose poultry were reared at government poultry farms and distributed at subsidized prices to farmers, and 1,400 turkey poultry were distributed to needy farmers at half the rate. Under specialized livestock breeding program, cattle feed and calf feed at 75% subsidy to the non-members of milk cooperative societies were distributed. A key village unit for providing veterinary services has been completed in Murugunum village and is to be opened shortly. For veterinary education, grant in aid to the extent of 12 crores was released to Rajiv Gandhi Institute of Veterinary College Education and Research, and the number of seats in graduation courses have been increased from 60 to 70 to 80. Art and culture. In order to facilitate the student community to excel in competitive examinations, reference books were purchased to the tune of 12.50 lakhs for Roman Roland Library. Government branch libraries, which were functioning in private buildings at Embalum, Nettakkam, Suthukkani, and Thiruvadikkoli Koil, have been shifted to government owned buildings. Financial assistance to the tune of 93 lakhs was dispersed to indigenous artists, Tamil scholars, and Kalaimarini awardees. Financial assistance of 15.16 lakh was granted as first installment for manuscript grant to 86 local authors. In commemoration of 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, Kavi Sammelan recital of Gandhi poems and cultural programs were conducted. Commercial taxes. As the honorable members are aware, that the commercial taxes department contributes to about 45% of Union Territory's own resources. The revenue collection, including GST compensation, from Government of India for the year 2018-19 stood at 2,131 crores, which is 272 crores over and above the last year revenue collection of 1,859 crores. E-way bill system under GST Act has also been successfully implemented in the Union Territory of Puducherry from 1st April 2018. 5,294 dealers have obtained new registration GST with effect from its implementation on 1st July 2017. Civil Supplies and Consumer Affairs. Honourable members are aware that under the state scheme, 20 kgs of free rice per month is distributed to all BPL and AA card holders, and 10 kgs of rice per month is distributed for all APL card holders of Puducherry, Karaikal and Yanam region. For Mahir region, 15 kgs of rice plus 5 kgs of wheat to BPL AA card holders and 5 kg rice plus 5 kg wheat to APL card holders are distributed. Under the scheme, cash subsidy was earlier promptly credited to the bank accounts of the beneficiary under the DBT mode in lieu of rice. Food subsidy rice is being distributed to an average of 3.35 lakh family ration card holders per month. The DBT mode of payment is implemented under the Universal Public Distribution System of Government of India. The subsidy amount is disbursed at the rate of 1,050.70 per card for 35 kgs of rice to the poorest of the poor under the AAY scheme for below poverty line BPL and 150.10 per member for 5 kg of rice. Accordingly, an average of 10.67 crore is being spent per month from the central assistance, through which nearly 1.71 lakh family ration card holders receive the benefits. School education. Needless to say that the learning process in school is instrumental to shaping of one's character and personality. Education must facilitate the cultivation of a healthy thought process and groom our cognitive abilities. In the present competitive world, education is a basic necessity. In order to promote the school education among the children, this government has taken various initiatives such as free distribution of textbooks, notebooks, uniforms, benefiting 1,07,8,51 students. 1,07,8,51 students. Transport facilities to school students at concessional rate under 1 rupee bus pass, 1 rupee bus scheme. Conduct of subject-wise motivational classes for SSLC and plus two students to improve the pass percentage of government school students. NEET coaching classes are conducted in 3 centres in Puducherry region and 1 in Karaikal. Smart classrooms have been established in 133 government schools under the CSR and Rurban Mission. 21 schools have been selected by Atal Innovation Mission to set up Atal Tinkering Laboratories. 3 students and 1 supervisor were selected and deputed to participate in the Sakura Science Exchange program to visit Japan for a week during the month of April 2018. Under state pre-matric scholarship to other economically backward classes, students, 1.53 crore was sanctioned to 24,996 OEBC students. We should happily inform the honorable members that in 2018-19, the pass percentage in 10th, 11th and 12th standard in government schools is significantly improved to this due to the sincere efforts of the education department. The following table will show the commendable performance. 10th standard increases by 6.79%. 11th standard increases by 10%, 10.83%. 12th standard increases by 11.86%. I take this opportunity to convey my sincere appreciation to the education department, particularly to the teaching community, for the contribution to the above achievements. I take this opportunity to inform the honorable members that 7 schools have been selected from this Union Territory for national award under the Swachh Vidyalaya Puraskar 17-18. Puducherry district has been selected for 5 national awards and ranked number 1 district in the country. Karaikal district was selected for 2 national awards and ranked number 3 in the country. Revised guidelines prioritizing government school students for admission in 11th standard in government higher secondary schools in Puducherry and Karaikal regions were issued in May 2018. Construction sports complex Lost Pit was completed. Building was inaugurated by Honorable Vice President in July 2018. Detailed project reports for construction rural sports stadiums with financial assistance under CSR was sent to Airport Authority of India, and approval for the construction of 4 indoor stadiums was received from AIA in March 2019. MOU has also been signed with AIA Higher and Technical Education. I'm happy to inform the honourable members, 5,389 students pursuing professional courses were benefited by Perumthovalur Kamarajar Financial Assistance Scheme, and 41 crores was given to students on this count in 2018-19. A new postgraduate centre for arts and science courses was started in the name of Dr. Kalignar M. Karunadi Postgraduate Centre in the premises of the Aligner Anna Government Arts and Science College Karikal. Admission for the arts and science courses, polytechnics, fine arts and hotel management have been brought within the purview of CENTAC from the academic year 2018-19. A common online admission course covering all higher secondary, higher education courses was introduced in the UT in 2018, which is the first of its kind in the country. 240 seats were increased in 4 courses in Puducherry Engineering College under self-finance scheme, and 130 under graduation seats were increased at Tagore Government Arts College, Puducherry, in various branches. 25.63 acres of land of Agriculture Department will be transferred to the Directorate of Higher and Technical Education, Puducherry, during April 2018 for construction of buildings at Karikal for Peruthunavalar Kamarajar Institute of Engineering College and Women's Polytechnic College. A new online college management system was launched in 2018, which provides the details of attendance of students, teachers and staff and daily activities of colleges. Further, all academic details of the institution, including courses offered, syllabus, admission details, course coverage, teaching and evaluation process, profile of students and staff have been made available in public domain. I'm proud to share with the honorable members that 3 higher education institutions functioning in this Union Territory have ranked better, which evidently proves Union Territory continued excellence in higher education. I also wish to inform that Puducherry Engineering College ranks 76th among the 969 engineering colleges of the country studied for ranking by the National Institute of Ranking Framework 2019. Similarly, Kanchi Mamunvar Center for Postgraduate Studies secured 49th rank among arts and science institutions in 2018-19 among 1,304 arts and science colleges. Tagore Government Arts and Science College and Indira Gandhi for Arts and Science ranked between 100th and 150th position among arts and science colleges. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar Polytechnic College, Jhelum, has got accreditation by the National Board of Accreditation during June 2018. Electricity. In order to meet the increasing power demand and to avail centrally allocated cheaper power for Karikal region from central and generating stations, 230 kV Karikal Bahur line and Karikal Neveli line and a new 230-110 kV substation at Pillaithuru Whistle of Karikal region were technically commissioned after synchronization with Southern Regional Grid at a project cost of around 48.17 crores. Under RAPDRP Part A scheme, a new system has been established at a cost of 8.32 crores for the automation of operation and control of HT feeders, distribution transformers and monitoring of power outflow by setting up control center with associated RTUs and communication facilities. The smart grid pilot project at a cost of 33.83 crore is implemented under the National Smart Grid Mission with 50% grant from the Government of India and balance to investor come service provider. So far, 27,500 smart meters were fixed in the town areas and the smart grid control center has been completed. Under the scheme Pradhan Mantri Sahaj Bijli Har Ghar Yojana, power supply was effected to 912 domestic services under Gram Swaraj Abhiyan. All the 382,100 households in the Union Territory of Puducherry have been 100% electrified. Under the scheme Ujala, 55,500 LED bulbs were distributed to consumers of Puducherry and Karikal regions. Fishermen and fisheries welfare. Fisheries sector occupies a very important place in the socio-economic development of the country. It's been recognized as a powerful income and employment generator as it stimulates growth of a number of subsidiary industries. It is also a source of cheap and nutritious food besides being a foreign exchange earner. Most importantly, it is a source of livelihood for a large section of economically backward population who are domiciled in the coastal area. The government has always shown keen interest in the welfare of fishing community in the Union Territory of Puducherry. To support them, band relief assistance was provided during ban period, 61 days at the rate of 5,500 for 70,262 families in Puducherry, Karakal and Yanam regions in 2018-19. For Mahe, region ban assistance at the rate of 469,052 days was dispersed to 545 families with a total expenditure of 11.62 crores. 6,949 aged fishermen were granted old age pension to the tune of 12.24 crores. Lean assistance at the rate of 2,500 per family was given to 17,807 families for a total amount of 445 crores. Similarly, reactivation charges was granted at the rate of 20,000 and 10,000 to 257 steel wooden mechanized boats and FRP boats respectively. Construction of fishery harbour at Yanam with an estimated cost of 19 crores was completed, inaugurated for the use of landing jetty and other ancillary facilities. Under the centrally sponsored scheme, Savings Cum Relief Fund, 60 lakh was dispersed to 3,358 active fishermen beneficiaries of Yanam region at the rate of 2,700 each, meant for the year 59 lakh was released by the Government of India for the scheme motorization of traditional crafts and safety of fishermen at sea for 2018-19. Besides a detailed project report, which includes 17 various projects with an estimated cost of 192.52 crores, has been sent to Government of India under the Blue Revolution. Integrated Development Management of Fisheries. I take this opportunity to share with the Honourable Members as Administrator that for the upgradation of existing fishing harbour at Thangapattu, Puducherry at an estimated cost of 15.63 has been accorded by Government of India. Forest and Wildlife. This government has initiated various measures to enhance the green cover and to protect the wild animals through existing Forest Act and Wildlife Protection Act. So far, 50,000 forest tree seedlings have been planted along the roadsides, tank bunds, educational institutions, industries, agricultural lands, etc. Nearly 2 lakh saplings were distributed to public schools, NGOs, industrial institutions to motivate tree planting. An extent of 50 hectares of land has been covered under the Social Forestry Scheme and Agro-Industry. Under the enforcement activities, special efforts were taken to safeguard the existing standing trees and also to prevent wild animal poaching and hunting. Awareness program for conservation and protection of mangrove forests was also organized. Health and Family Welfare. I wish to apprise the Honourable Members of this August House that in order to ensure adequate qualitative, preventive and curative health care services to all, this government has taken various steps in this direction. Government has spent around 7.5% of total outlay of state budget for health care in 2018-19, which evidently shows the firm commitment of the government to providing health care for all. Gives me immense pleasure to note that this Union Territory continues to rank high in many crucial health indicators which have received wider accolades. The government has recently transferred land measuring 50 acres to Jitme for building an exclusive organ transplant wing at Sedrapet, wherein various organs will be harvested for transplantation, and Government of India has sanctioned 582 crores for this project. Jitme has proposed to give 30 crores for renovation of General Hospital, Karakal and purchase of medical equipment there. A MOU has been signed with Jipmer for providing speciality facilities in Yanam region, for which Government of India has earmarked 48 crores in the first phase for building a multi-speciality unit at Yanam and improving the infrastructure facilities of General Hospital Yanam at an estimated cost of 99 crores. Newly constructed sub-centre under the control of Primary Health Centre, Sorapet, was inaugurated, which aims at catering to health services for about 4,000 population in and around the area of Selipet and Bambupet. I deem it appropriate to mention here about the growth and achievement of the Indira Gandhi Medical College and Research Institute. The medical institution is located in the heart of the city of Puducherry with an annual submission of 150 admission of 150 students. Started in a small scale in an attached teaching hospital in the year 2010, the college has rapidly progressed into full-fledged recognized medical college with 750-bedded hospital with the active support from the government. Puducherry University has recently given affiliation to start PG courses in 10 other disciplines for which the Unitarity of Health and Family Welfare has been approached for approval. Hindu religious institutions. Temple directory both in English and Tamil language consists of vital information, history of temples, puja timings, sacred times, temple cards, contact details, affiliated temples along with historical trace of the temple concerned, temples of sacred saints, siddhas, etc. was released. I'm sure that this directory will be immensely useful to the people of Puducherry and tourists as well. Anadhan Dhanam scheme has been implemented in 5 major temples in Puducherry and Karaikal region. Training on HRI Act and rules to the Board of Trustees, Special Officers, Executive Officers of the temples situated in Puducherry and Alberate municipalities was imparted so as to manage the affairs of temples more effectively. Similarly, 3 months training classes were conducted to Gurukul Achagars, Pujaris of the temples at Puducherry region through Vedhasrama Gurukulam at Karu Vadikupum, Puducherry. 1 crore was spent on various renovation repair works in 60 purview temples and non-purview temples. Educational scholarship to 1,165 Muslim minority students and monthly pension at the rate of 2,000 per month to 10 retired ulamas who had registered in Bucks were distributed. Industries. Wish to inform that all honourable members that 27 projects have been cleared with an investment of 117.50 crores ever since the notification of the new industrial policy. The Industrial Guidance Bureau has processed 37 applications for setting up of industries in the Union Territory of Puducherry. To attract investment in the field of electronics and IT, an investor meet was organized in January 2019 in association with NITI Aayog, Manufacturing Association of Information Technology, and India's Cellular and Electronics Association. Leading companies participated in the meet. $5 billion investment and 50,000 additional jobs are expected to be generated in the Union Territory of Puducherry in the coming years. Capital investment subsidy of 67 lakhs was released to 32 industrial units under the subsidy scheme, Motivation of Entrepreneurs to Start Industries, and fiscal assistance to industries under the training scheme. 167 unemployed youth completed in-plant and advanced training. 526 persons were trained under the scheme's development of COIR and development of handicrafts. 164 entrepreneurs were sanctioned loan for an amount of 1.60 crores to various banks as they received subsidy of 51.36 lakhs under the scheme Motivation of Unemployed Persons to Start Self-Employed Enterprises. Under Prime Minister's Employment Generation Programme, 45 entrepreneurs were sanctioned loan to the tune of 2.40 crores and marginal money released for an amount of 92 lakhs. Information technology. Information technology has become an integral part of governance. All the government departments of this administration have been making maximum use of information technology in their day-to-day affairs. As a part of the IT initiative under the Online Service Management Scheme, Manav Sampada, the service records of all employees are being uploaded and maintained digitally, which will eventually replace the manual service book of employees, helping in streamlining the records. As of now, 55 departments have updated the service records of 11,786 employees. On completion of registration, service details will be fully digitized. In order to enable the public to get stamped paper in their nearest location, 16 common service centers have been recognized to deliver e-stamped papers. Under Pradhan Mantri Grameen Digital Sakshata Abhiyan, 9,200 persons have been trained to make them digitally literate. Labour. Skill development training programs, especially for SC women, were conducted in various trades for 5 days with a view to supplementing their family income through self-employment, in which SC women hailing from the labourers' families participated. Vocational Career Guidance Bulletin, both Tamil and English, was published for 10th and 12th standard separately and distributed to the higher school and higher secondary schools of Puducherry to facilitate the school leaving students to pursue their higher education. 2 days training program was conducted by the teachers of the government and private schools to undertake online registration of 10th and 12th standard students with employment exchange at the concerned school itself, so as to avoid hardship to the students in getting their qualification registered with employment exchange. Training on GST with tally was imparted to 48 SC candidates in order to encourage self-employment and enable them to get employment in private concerns. A career guidance exhibition was held at Gandhi Thidal, Puducherry for 3 days, in which 30 colleges participated and 2,348 candidates visited. Under upgradation of 400 ITIs through vocational training improvement project with World Bank assistance, 6 trades were taken up at government ITI. Men, TR Patanam, Karikal, and a project cost of 2.20 crores. First time a 10 kV solar grid power plant was installed at the cost of 8.67 lakhs at government ITI Netapakkam, Puducherry. Local administration. I'm immensely happy to mention here, Puducherry has been declared as open defecation free state. 4,573 individual household toilets were constructed at a cost of 11 crores. In order to maintain hygiene and promote basic amenities for the general public, the Union Territory Puducherry, 9 community toilets and 13 public toilets have been constructed in various urban areas at an expense of 2 crores. All the 112 municipal wards, 12 in Puducherry municipality, 37 in Aldrich, 18 in Karikal, and 15 in Mahe, and 10 in Yala municipality have been declared as open defecation free. Solid waste management projects were implemented by waste processing methods such as recycling, composting, and vermicomposting. Methanation and biomethanation involving an expenditure of 2.90 crores. Further, it is proposed to obtain 17 crores from Government of India under centrally sponsored scheme for handling the various solid waste management projects. The clean Puducherry is our objective, and the state will strive hard to achieve garbage-free Puducherry so that the garbage disposal issue will be settled once and for all. Police. In order to strengthen the police machinery, the Union Ministry of Home Affairs has released an amount of 3.23 crores as central assistance under the scheme Nationwide Emergency Response System, and in an amount of 98 lakhs has already been released to Centre for Development of Advanced Computing to start the project. Similarly, 1.48 crore has been released as grant in aid for the purpose of setting up of a cyber forensic lab cum training centre towards implementation of the project Cyber Crime Prevention Against Women and Children. To protect the coastal area, Government of India has sanctioned 2.44 crores for construction of 3 coastal police stations, one each at Puducherry, Mahe and Yana, and 2 jetties, one each at Karikal and Puducherry. The works have already been completed in Puducherry, Karikal, Yana regions, and it will commence shortly in Mahe. Port. Due to sustained efforts of the government, the pilot project of construction of a near shore reef to retain beaches along the shoreline of Puducherry town, funded by the National Institute of Ocean Technology, Chennai, has been completed at a project cost of 30 crores. Upward revision of port tariff, port dues such as port dues, landing and shipping dues, and vehicle entry fee for commercial port operations have been notified in the official gazette of Puducherry. On account of operations at the private port at Karikal, 11 crores was earned as revenue during 18-19 in the form of concession fee. Public works. I wish to inform the honourable members that despite financial constraint, the government is keen on creation of maintenance of vital infrastructure facilities like roads, bridges, irrigation, flood control and water supply projects. 9 major water supply projects in various localities were completed with a total expenditure of 20 crores, which includes 7 works in Puducherry, provision of water purification system in 10 locations of Karikal, and 1 work in Dharyathipa in Yanam region. Desilting of various channels at Karikal district involving 3 crores, and 11 building construction works for 40 crores, consisting of 7 works in Puducherry, 31 crores, one work each in Karikal, 5 crores, and Mahe, 2 crores, and 2 works in Yanam, 1.34 were undertaken. In roads and bridges sector, 7 major road works, including construction of road overbridge, strengthening improvement of existing roads were completed, involving an expenditure of 71 crores. Negotiated loan to the extent of 100 crores was availed from HUDCO and NABARD for various ongoing projects, and many works are nearing completion. Kaveri River dispute, including the court cases, were effectively followed up in order to protect the interests of Government of Puducherry. As per the order of the Honorable Supreme Court of India, 7 TMC water has been allocated to the Union Territory of Puducherry. Revenue. 10 crore has been released to Karaikal region for relief and rehabilitation measures towards damages loss caused by Gaja cyclone in 2018-19 from Puducherry Disaster Response Fund. Similarly, 1.50 crore for Yanam region was released for relief and restoration measures towards loss caused by floods. 1,113 families were benefited under Rajiv Gandhi Social Security Scheme for poor families. 2012 involving an expenditure of 4 crores, 6 modern record rooms at a cost of 2 crores have been set up in the Directorate of Survey and Land Records, Puducherry, and in all taluk offices of Puducherry. Rural development. This government is implementing various poverty elevation and employment generation schemes, especially for socio-economic upliftment of rural population under Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme. 6 lakh man days were generated. Under this program, 121 works were completed in 2018-19, incurring an expenditure of 15 crores. Construction of 9,302 toilets have been completed and 10,402 toilets are under construction. 98 Gram Panchayats were declared as open defecation free under Swachh Bharat Mission. 26,623 households have mobilized themselves into self-help groups, and 281 habitation level federation have been formed. Revolving fund has been provided to 566 SAGs. 95 panchayat level federations have been formed, and community involvement investment fund was given to 47 panchayat level federations. Science, technology and environment. As the honorable members are well aware, environmental protection is one of the challenging tasks before the government. To conserve natural resources and to prevent pollution, this government has been taking effective measures. During 18-19, 9 industrial units have installed continuous online emission monitoring system. For continuously monitoring the quality and quantity of wastewater discharge and or air emissions, financial assistance of 20 lakhs each was extended to Puducherry and Karaikal municipalities for establishing and operating biomethanation plant for disposal of solid waste, and the same are operational in both the municipalities. A pilot scale project on restoration of Puducherry beach through construction of near shore wedge reef, 1 offshore reef and sand nourishment, the cost of 30 crores was implemented through the NIOD, Ministry of Earth Sciences. The Puducherry Coastal Zone Management Plan maps prepared by the Institute of Remote Sensing, Anna University, Chennai, under Coastal Disaster Risk Reduction Project funded by World Bank, has been approved by Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Town and Country Planning. Honorable members will appreciate the fact that any imbalance between the prevailing land values and financial capacity of individuals obviously makes purchasing, building a house much beyond the reach of urban poor. As such, slum upgradation is the need of the hour as a part of the Mission 96 dwelling units at Chinnapuram, Kuruchikpam, Puducherry, with an estimated cost of 11 crores have been completed and allotted to the beneficiaries under the slum upgradation program. Under the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana scheme, 4 projects have been got approved under the beneficiary-led construction component to construct 1,580 houses. Further, 3 projects have been submitted to Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs for approval to construct 397 houses for SE beneficiaries. Tourism. The tourism sector in Puducherry Union Territory is registering a constant growth, and there was about 8% increase in tourist arrival during the last year. Puducherry is a well-known weekend tourism for tourists. Beach development at Wembak, Heer, Palyam, Veerapatnam, Chinna Veerapatnam beaches have been completed. In addition, Kirumakkamam lake was taken up for development at a cost of 9 crores. Arts and Crafts Village at Murugan Pakkam has been established to promote village crafts. A beach resort at Karikal was operationalized by Indian Tourism Development Corporation. Work for development of museum and interpretation center at Arkimedo at a cost of 10 crores was taken up in order to generate additional revenue and to encourage private participation in tourism industry. Action has been taken to outsource operation and maintenance of the new asset. Transport. In order to avoid road accidents, regular road safety awareness programs were conducted. Apart from this, traffic rules were strictly enforced, which has considerably brought down the incidence of traffic violations and rash driving. The Vahan software with online facility for registration of vehicle has been introduced and is successfully functioning in all regional transport offices and its unit offices in the Union Territory of Puducherry. The e-auction of fancy number is being carried out since July 2018. Revenue collection through transport department is 2018-19 was 114 crores. Motor vehicle tax including entry tax was revised after a long gap of 10 years, which is expected to improve the revenue collection considerably. In order to redress genuine public grievances against auto rickshaws, Meghdoot postcard complaint mechanism was introduced. 1 lakh postcards was printed and distributed to the general public for this purpose. Ali Dravidar and Scheduled Tribe Welfare. Government of Puducherry is implementing various welfare schemes for scheduled castes and scheduled tribes people to improve their socio-economic and educational status in this union territory. An amount of 283 crores was spent under SCSP component in 2018-19. Under Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, subsidy scheme in amount of 6.45 crores was sanctioned in the first installment to 17-18 SC beneficiaries. Under the Bharat Ratna Rajiv Gandhi House Construction Subsidy Scheme, an amount of 16 crores was sanctioned in second and third installments for 1070 SC beneficiaries for construction of well-designed concrete house. Financial assistance of 5,000 to the bride's marriage belonged to SC's community to 106 families was granted with the intention of reducing the infant mortality rate. Financial assistance of 12,000 and 6,000 at postnatal per beneficiaries is provided to the pregnant and lactating women, under which 807 SC women were benefited. I'm happy to share with the honourable members, financial assistance to pregnant and lactating women has been enhanced from 12,000 to 18,000 with effect from December 2018. In order to help the SC families who are suffering from various prolonged illnesses, AD Welfare Department provides medical assistance of 3,000 per month during the year 2018. An amount of 3.80 crores was disbursed to 2,301 SC beneficiaries. As a part of government's initiative to eradicate the untouchability in the society, an incentive of 1,100,50 is granted to interstate marriage couples. Accordingly, 167 married couples were benefited, and incentive amount has been enhanced from 1 lakh to 2.50 lakh with effect from September 2017. An amount of 16 crores was spent to carry out 150 civic amenities works like roads, community halls, waterborne latrines, etc. in SC habitations in Union Territory Puducherry through PADCO. In addition to the above, financial assistance to the extent of 28 crores was disbursed to 225 SC students for their educational pursuits, training and self-employment. Happy to inform the honourable members on this occasion, the one SC community ruler, Willy and Vatakarun, has been notified under the President Notification of Puducherry Scheduled Tribes Act 2016, which is a long pending demand of the community. This would pave the way for upliftment of their education and employment service avenues in government services. Backward classes and minorities welfare. In order to support the backward classes students, 6 boys girls hostels are functioning, of which 3 are located in Puducherry, 2 in Karikal and 1 in Yana. 236 inmates are staying in these hostels, and 1.77 crores were spent to meet the hostel needs. Under pre-matric and post-matric scholarship to backward classes, 1,109 students were benefited. Similarly, under pre-matric and post-matric scholarships to minorities, 1,266 students got benefit. Press boxes, barber chairs, thebil and nadhaskaran were distributed to poor artisans at free of cost with an expenditure of 30 lakhs. Under Makkal Thalayavar Thiyogi V. Subhaya award schemes to meritorious students, 13 students belonging to backward classes who were found meritorious in the school final exam were awarded cash prize. Social welfare. I'm really happy to share with the honourable members that in order to protect the interests of differently abled, 4% reservation in government recruitment, 5% reservation for higher and technical education were notified. 20,952 differently abled persons were given financial assistance ranging from 1,500 to 3,300 involving a monthly expenditure of 4.28 crores. Besides various welfare programs, financial assistance for marriage, eye donation, funeral expenses, fuel subsidy, transport allowance, free bus pass, scholarship, cash dole, in lieu of free gift for Diwali, reimbursement of educational expenses to hearing impaired were implemented. 582 beneficiaries were distributed prosthetic appliances in November 2018 amounting to 36 lakhs. Rashtriya Vayushri Yojana, a centrally sponsored scheme, was implemented successfully in Puducherry and Karikal district. 977 beneficiaries in Puducherry and 937 beneficiaries in Karikal were benefited and distributed medical devices like hearing aid, dental accessories in association with Artificial Limbs Manufacturing Corporation of India as per their requirement. Women and child development. Honourable members are well aware that this government is committed to the upliftment of women and children of the Union Territory. Accordingly, financial assistance of 15,000 rupees for performance of marriage of poor brides was granted and 25,000 towards marriage of daughter of destitute widows was granted in 2018-19 in order to motivate the girl children from uninterrupted schooling. National saving certificates for 25,000 rupees were issued to seven single girl children studying in 8th to 10th, and financial assistance in the form of fixed deposit for a sum of 20,000 rupees was given to 453 poor parents who have one or two girl children and undergone family planning. Financial assistance of 6,000 was granted to 872 pregnant women and lactating mothers. Incentive of 50,000 rupees for widow remarriage was also granted. Under old age pension scheme, 1,44,847 persons of old age, unmarried women and transgender aware monthly financial assistance from the government. The financial assistance granted for performing funeral rites of deceased pensioners has been enhanced from 5,000 to 10,000 rupees with effect from 11-12-2018. Assistance granted immediately on the day of demise of the pensioner. On the occasion of Diwali festival, cash doles of 1,000 per ration card was directly paid to the bank account of all the red ration card holders. A sum of 12.56 crores was spent benefiting 365 days of the year to children aged up to 8 years and pregnant lactating women enrolled under the Integrated Child Development Services Scheme to 855 Anganwadi centres. 25,000 children and 9,000 mothers were benefited and a sum of 16 crores was spent for the scheme during the year to 18-19. Under the Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana scheme, cash incentive of 5,000 was transferred directly to the bank account of pregnant women lactating mothers for the first living child. A sum of 3 crores was spent under the scheme benefiting 7,385 women. I'd like to conclude my speech with a deep sense of contentment that the Union Territory has been progressing well in all spheres despite availability of limited resources and administrative constraints. It's also heartening to note that on account of prudent financial management, the Union Territory finances remain stable and all the fiscal parameters remain within the prescribed limits. Government of Puducherry will carry forward people-friendly policies, programs and schemes for the prosperity, welfare and progress of people of the Union Territory of Puducherry and take the Union Territory to new heights of excellence. Nandri and Jai Hind.